Hello and welcome to another episode of Home in the Earth. This one's about building up the tower walls with cinder block. I've always wanted to build a tower wall out of concrete blocks, so here we are. I position each block using that pivot pole from the center to mark the distance to the inside of each brick, and that way I'll make a perfect circle all the way around. Of course, the inside circumference of the bricks is smaller, so the bricks fit tightly there, but leave gaps on the outside. I don't want to trim the insides, I'm just going to pack the outsides. And I'm actually covering the outside in a surface bonding cement mix. It will actually tie things together and make it stronger than regular mortar would. It's like a cross between a stucco and a mortar, and it's filled with little glass fibers to help reinforce and prevent cracking. Don't buy the special surface bonding cement stuff for $25 a bag. Just buy bags of stucco and bags of mortar for $5 each and mix them at a ratio of 1:1. And then I often mix in a quarter measure of thinset to improve the spreadability of the mixture. It also adds some waterproofing additives that are in the thinset as well. I buy the 1-inch glass fibers separately in a 5-pound bag for $15, and then I use a handful of glass fibers per mixing bucket. Any more than that and it starts to become difficult to work with. Here Michael's stuffing scraps of XPS insulation into the voids in the bricks. We'll also be properly insulating the outside, but this internal XPS does help a little, and it's better than throwing those scraps in the garbage. After some time, Michael went down to help my dad with making the window bucks, and my mom took over the scrap insulation stuffing along with all the other tasks she was working. If you're wondering how the bricks get up there, we had a couple pallets delivered, and we carried them up by hand. Here's a pic of David and my dad working together to get a load up. Other times I did it, or worked with the boys, or sometimes the boys had competitions to see who could get more blocks up to the top. I just don't have any video of any of that. From this view, you can see the concrete beam that we're building above the mezzanine. This will be filled with rebar and concrete and will help spread the load of that section of wall across that flat roof section. We did a separate video on making that wooden floor section. I'll link that card in the top right corner now. In this scene, I'm cutting some notches in the tops of the bricks to run some ENT electrical conduit. That conduit will connect all the outlet boxes, and we'll pull the wires through later. Time to get out the laser. I'm setting up lines with the North Star for north, south, east, and west, and the 45 degrees in between. It looks perfect so far, but we'll have to be careful as we go on up to keep things leveled out. The next day, we are starting on the window box, aligned with those directions we marked out on the evening before. We glued those curve boards down just to locate things perfectly, and we'll end up attaching square window box on top of those later that will help hold the window with the nail flashing and all that. Time to fill this beam with rebar and concrete. Cutting the cement blocks is a hassle, so I was glad to have help, especially because we have a lot of cuts to fill all those spaces between the windows. Having two people where one person's cutting and the other one can place the blocks really makes it a lot easier. You don't have to keep stopping what you're doing and switching tasks. At this point, you're probably noticing that I'm only using the blocks on 3/4 of the circle. Those blocks are over the very strong concrete radial vault arches that won't even notice the weight. However, on that last quarter, we're building on top of that flat roof section, so we're going to use a lightweight concrete with bubbles in it, or EPS concrete or something like that. That'll be the next video. For now, I'm just getting the window box in place, secured to the concrete at the bottom of the wall. Now that I'm up to the top of the window wall, what do you think the next step is? First, I need to take a little time and repair my cheap little bandsaw. I had to replace the rubber around the pulleys because the blade kept falling off. It's not a great bandsaw, but it is useful for this next step. Here you can see I'm cutting in a curve that will match the top of that tower wall. I need a bunch of these, one to span the top of each window. I'm attaching those curved bits above the straight window box so that I can build a curved form for my round bond beam at the top of the wall. But before I get pouring that round bond beam, I need to fill in the lightweight wall in the next video. If you're interested in seeing that next step, EPS Concrete, please subscribe and click the little bell to get notified when that video is released.